Chairman 139, I think that between the Inspector General and this bill, boy, we could really straighten Rhode Island out and make it the shining example that it should be. And this is to basically outlaw the use of moral obligation bonds. In 1843, Rhode Island was the first state in the nation to place a restriction in the Constitution requiring that voters approve the incurring of state debt. Rhode Island actually did this to protect its taxpayers from costly economic development ventures that had bankrupted other states in the 1840s. So we have Article 6, Section 16 of our state constitution, which states that the General Assembly shall have no powers without the express consent of the people to incur state debts to an amount exceeding $50,000. And it goes on to say that nor shall it in any case without such consent pledge the faith of the state for the payment of obligation of others. Moral obligation bonds were created in 1960 in New York by John Mitchell, a prominent municipal bond lawyer, who was later convicted and sentenced to prison for his crimes associated with Watergate. The creation of this new scheme was to assist then Governor Nelson Rockefeller in avoiding voter approval to continue his ambitious government expansion projects, which the electorate had no appetite for and resisted. In the early 1970s, moral obligation bonds were introduced to Rhode Island by the late James Skeffington. After three voter rejections of economic development bonds in referenda between 1969 and 1972, a total disregard for the will of the electorate. Although moral obligation bonds became highly publicized as the vehicle that brought us the failed 38 Studios debacle, we have forgotten that the state's very first moral obligation bonds to promote economic development were issued in 1974 for Fairmount Foundry to purchase Grinnell Foundry. In 1976, the foundry failed and closed, leaving Rhode Island taxpayers with over a $4 million tab that they never approved. In 1993, a moral obligation bond was issued for a biotech company called Alpha Beta Technology. 6 years later, they closed, leaving Rhode Island taxpayers another $30 million tab, which was never approved. Fittingly, the state of New York, where moral obligation bonds were created, outlawed them in 1976. After a commission found that the debt that they created contributed to the state's fiscal crisis and concluded that the sale of such bonds created a dangerous and misleading illusion. Many times we as legislators are not looked upon favorably. It is precisely because of unconstitutional schemes like this that skirt their way around the will of the people. So that's about the history on if you appreciate and enjoy history as I do, but it's all factual information, so it's anybody can look it up, and this is what we do in this state, and we're looking at doing it again with a ballpark. So you know, it's certainly something to keep in mind. Thank you.
Quite welcome. Any questions of the sponsor?